Hey, toy fans, D21 Beast Rob here, back with another Marvel Legends review for you guys here today. And as you can plainly see, today is the day that we're going to build the Juggernaut Build-A-Figure, part of the 2016 X-Men wave of Marvel Legends figures released by Hasbro. Now, a couple of items of note before we get started. Phoenix over here is featuring a flame effect on her right hand. I forgot that I actually had this back when I reviewed her, but the Marvel Girl from Hasbro, actually one of the better offerings from the dark days of Hasbro Marvel Legends. She came with some attachable flame effects for her hands, and her right hand is actually molded in almost the exact same position as the right hand of the Phoenix figure. So if you have that Marvel Girl and still have her flame effects, go ahead and give that accessory a shot and see what you think of it. Also, I was asked in my review of Rogue why I never featured a shot of the Toy Biz Gambit figure and Rogue standing next to each other. Well, here you go. Sorry I didn't think of it back during the review, but in the grand scheme of things, Rogue's probably spent more time with Magneto as a love interest in the comic books than she actually has Gambit, so I guess that pairing kind of slipped my mind. Alright, housekeeping out of the way, let's remind you what pieces came with what figures. Iceman came with the left arm for Juggernaut, Wolverine the head, Rogue the left leg, Shadowcat the right arm, Havoc his right leg, Cable came with his lower torso, and finally Phoenix came with Juggernaut's upper torso. Alright, toy fans, time to put this unstoppable brute together and see what he's all about. Alright, toy fans, here we have the Juggernaut Build-A-Figure fully assembled, and it is a behemoth of a figure. Juggernaut first appeared in X-Men number 12, back from 1965. He was created by Stan Lee and Jack Kirby, and he's a character that a lot of people forget isn't actually a mutant. No, it's actually the Crimson Bands of Sidorak that Xavier's half-brother Kane Marco actually draws his power from, the bands that you can see actually make up part of the character's costume. And that gives us a good place to start with the sculpting for this figure. It's worth noting that the bands on the arm of this figure are actually kind of movable. They are separate pieces that have been placed on the figure's arm, except for where the hands are concerned. That's actually part of the entire sculpt. I love the look of the eyes. They've been painted very cleanly. We even get some nice eyebrow detail inside the eyelids for the mask. Coming down the figure, we've got some nice gum-colored paint applied to the mouth, as well as some nice yellowish, crooked, jagged teeth. A great look for the character, but that detail kind of ends when we come down to the torso of this figure. It's a very flat plastic. It does look like the costume should, but it doesn't maintain the detail or the paint wash that we saw on the helmet. It's also worth noting that there's sort of a sculpted belly button in this costume, so it's very clear that Hasbro wants to keep this body on retainer for any other larger characters that they want to use. They can remold the arms, just not have the rings, and have possibly a shirtless character or another sort of skin-tight outfit. I do wish that the sculpt for this figure was just a little more customized to the Juggernaut, but I do like the way it looks overall. It's just kind of a minor gripe of mine. Coming down, we do have a belt piece that's kind of loose. Again, sculpted detail here as well to kind of match the helmet. There's even a paint wash in the buckle. And then as we come down the legs of the figure, massive, massive legs for this figure. And then we have some more sculpted detail on the actual boots for the character. I like the line coming down the front. There's even some tread sculpted around the edge of the boot. But then coming up the back of the figure, we can again see there's not really a lot in the way of sculpted texture, but we do have the paint lines from the abdomen on the front continued around to the back. Overall, this Juggernaut figure does what it needs to sell the look of the figure. Now, I do need to come clean a little bit. I did a vlog a couple of months back where I shared my thoughts on the new Juggernaut Build-A-Figure among all the other figures in this wave, and I did think that Juggernaut was going to reuse the body mold from the Rhino figure just smoothed out. Well, as you can see, this Juggernaut figure dwarfs the size of this Rhino figure. There are no shared pieces between these two figures. Articulation-wise, I'm happy with the range of motion on this Juggernaut figure. The head's been sculpted in such a way that the dome can actually look up just a little bit and look down, which is nice. I was worried that he wouldn't be able to look up or down at all, really. He can look left and right just fine. His abs do bend forward decently enough that you can kind of get his head almost in a charging position, and he folds back pretty nicely, too. Full rotation here at the shoulder, bends out from the body that far, upper bicep swivel right here. Single jointed elbow that's a bit tight on this figure. Wrist does rotate all the way around and bend back that far and down that far. He's got a rotation here at the waist, ball-jointed hips, so his leg can kind of go forward about that far, back not so much, out from the body, okay, upper thigh swivel, single-jointed knee, and then he's got a foot that will bend forward, not too far, back very far, and he's got that great Hasbro ankle pivot. If you're comparing Juggernaut to a standard 6-inch figure from the Marvel Legends line, this brute of a figure does seem a bit lacking, but given the size and the positions I'm able to strike with this character, I'm actually pretty impressed. It's a lot better than anything I was ever able to do with the Marvel Select version of the character. And hey, why not do a comparison with that figure right now? On the right of your screen, we do have the Marvel Select Juggernaut figure, and of course we've got the Hasbro Build-A-Figure on the left. And while this figure does have a lot more texture detail, and even an overall darker color scheme, I do actually think I'm liking the more comic-friendly look of the Hasbro Build-A-Figure in this case. But this isn't actually the first time we've received a Juggernaut from the Marvel Legends line. Let's pull the Select out of the way, and replace it with the original Toy Biz Juggernaut figure. Now this figure was actually great in its day, and truly massive for a Toy Biz era Marvel Legends figure that wasn't a Build-A-Figure. We even got a removable helmet with this figure, which was a great touch. There's better paint detail, and even more articulation on the Toy Biz Juggernaut than we're getting with the Hasbro version. But the proportions on this Toy Biz figure are really quite wonky. His arms are almost dragging on the ground, and I feel like you just see joints everywhere you look at this figure. Great in its day, but I do feel Hasbro's offering has the edge. Here's all the Juggernauts compared together, and it's going to be the Hasbro version that now sits on my shelf for the foreseeable future. Even if he comes up just a little bit too tall. How tall? Well, here he is compared to all the other figures available in this wave. Height-wise, this Juggernaut figure comes in at 8.5 inches tall. And here he is compared to the 6-inch scaled Marvel Legends Infinite Series Wolverine.
You're not a man, you're a skyscraper! Ha ha ha! Thanks, Tiny! Don't mention it.
Alright, toy fans, well, that's my review of the Marvel Legends X-Men Wave Juggernaut Build-A-Figure released by Hasbro in 2016. Overall, if you want this Build-A-Figure, you're going to need to drop the money on all 8 figures in this X-Men Wave. Now, sometimes with Marvel Legends, that means you get a couple duds in the mix just so you can finish a Build-A-Figure. But in this case, you get a fantastic set of 8 X-Men characters, most of them superior redos to figures we've had in the past, and then you get your just rewards with a phenomenal Juggernaut Build-A-Figure. I'm wearing my heart on my sleeve on this one, but this is definitely a Wave and Build-A-Figure you want to pick up. Well, thanks for watching this review, toy fans. I hope you enjoyed it. Who's your favorite figure out of this entire wave? It's been a tough choice for me, but I'm giving the number one slot to that brand new Wolverine figure. You guys can always keep up with me on Twitter and Instagram at D21Beast, and I'll see you guys next time.